So, I got some new plants set up. I bought these. These are like hanging things for these specific planters that are from Biolan. And I really like this. These are really easy to water. And actually, this little cakey here needs watering just now. So, I'm going to show how easy these orchid pots are to water. I'm not sure can you get those. These are from Biolan, and Biolan is Finnish-based company. I think, at least I haven't seen this elsewhere. And this cake has a little bit of growth going on. It's setting up new leaf there. So, please excuse my dishes here. I just eat breakfast and I'm too lazy to do anything. And because this is cakey, I'm not going to fertilize it. And I use like room temperature water for orchids. And here in Finland we have really soft water, so we don't need like do anything about it. And now I'm just going to. I usually try to water these over the roots and really be careful not to like let water go through the in the crown or near the leaves. I usually water just here. And I'll water until this white pot is full. And I see when it's full because it starts to like floating a little bit, so when you see orchid move, it's like now. Now it's rising. So I know it's now full. And I leave it there for like hour or so. And when it's ready, I can open this tap, but now it's close it. So I will be back in hour to show how easy this is empty. And now it's been about 1 hour, and I'll open this tap. And water is just like coming out. This is really easy way to water them. Actually, I don't need to like take it out of the stand. I could like use the, what is this called? The thing you use to water plant, like put it back. But I like to bring them here. Also because up here I can more closely like monitor the health and everything. And this is very healthy little orchid. This is it's like cakey, pretty large cakey actually now, and it's making new leaf, and I hope that it will grow bigger and be blooming sometime. And I'm currently doing these watercolor miniature paintings. I'm masking this first one. Started to like give the flat colors. I'm not yet sure will I do the background like matte black or some color stuff. I think I go with matte black. I like that more. And here you can see my camera is pointing. So, and because I'm filming this small thing, you see that there isn't like that much between camera and work. It's really close. And that means when I like are painting, I have to make sure that I'm not like leaning too much in front. Well, it's impossible to lean in the camera because it's now so close that I will hit my head on that. But actually when painting, I try to not like cover the whole painting with my hand. So hopefully this will turn out well. I'm using Core watercolors, by the way. This is my main Core palette. All of these colors are from Core. This one actually is from Daniel and Smith. And here are four whole paints. And this one is from Daniel Smith. But every other color is from Core. Golden Core. I know, everybody says they are expensive paints and that they behave oddly when wet, but I like them. And I don't clean my palette. I find it's easier to look like natural looking paintings when you have some not like super clean colors. I actually clean it here a little bit so I can put my new colors there. But here's my green bottle, and there was my brown bottle. And if you wonder what these are, When I like these colors here on the pants, they a little bit leaked on this palette side. So here are my, well, it's my brown mix. It's actually really great because it's closely to skin tone. I use that often. And here are my acrylic painting stuff. And actually I just got my mirror tube out because I didn't like how that my, well, tentacles in the hat were doing. I was debating to do the suction cups, but I think I'm not going to do those. And I think I will tone those a little bit more yellow and brownish tones than those green one. I'm using this permanent green middle now, but it's, how can I say, it's not that good. It's really bad color. I think I'm maybe switching to this one. And that's the like great thing working with acrylics, because you can just layer and layer and layer, nothing bad happens. Especially because I'm working with ultra smooth canvas, so I'm not like losing the tooth of canvas because there's tiny at the first place. Also, I will do like the black shadow under the monster. So yeah, that was I am currently working on. Look what is here. It's gloss. It's my butter gloss. Oh, it's a cute package. Aww. There's chromium oxide. Oh, I love it. I love green colors, and I find chromium oxide is actually a really beautiful green color. Even it's opaque because it makes so natural greens. And full pan of manganese blue. I'm so excited that I can talk today. I'm so happy now. Ooh, a little dab of good cobalt turquoise and all the swatch cards. Oh, these are really great. This is one reason why I like to buy handmade water glass, because packaging is all so special every time. I feel like I don't want to open this because it's so cute. And these are from Penholder Art UK, and I will link the shop down below in description. But I can't open it just by one hand. I'm gonna put my trumpets on. No, it's not. No, it's really. Immediately when I saw this set, I knew I had to get this. I was like, no, I'm going to buy the one. And you will soon see why. It has orchid on the cover. I couldn't resist. It's so just so. And there's sap green, burnt sienna, sunflower yellow, magnet, and taylor blue. And the respective watch cards are here. I think this is a really great color for orchids. I think it's actually like the exact tone of one of my orchids. So here are the. No, this is my blue. Yeah. So here are the watch cards. I'm so excited to open this packages. These are like candies. They are so beautiful wrapped. I have just like edited 4 hours straight my newest like miniature painting series. It was horrible to edit. I don't know. I have no clue that every time I go mix paint or take water, my hand covers the whole like frame, and it was horrible. I had to cut so much out, and because I was painted the painting already, I didn't want to throw the footage out, so I had to make it work. Now I said like 4 hours work. I'm not sure how I do the rest of it. I really want to do the series, but I have feeling that I just don't want to edit 4 hours straight anymore. It's too demanding. And also because I have my master thesis work going on right now, I have to like use time on that too, and it takes so much of my like daily time. So yeah, life happens. It's really, it's sometimes really hard to be like hobbyist artist because you don't have all the time you have in your for your art. You have something else that takes like a bunch of your time, like work or for me school. So yeah, but I have something new to show you. It's my new orchids. I'm not sure was I in frame last time. I'm not sure. But here is my orchid. This all came from Poland. This is Dorian Theopsis Sokovivien. As you can see, it has this lovely striped leaves. And these lighter spots are just like reminders of like fungicide and hard water and those kind of skin things. I'm going to clean those off. It is old flower spike, so this is blooming size. It's really nicely sized. It has like 6 leaves, so it can do other flower spike anytime. Yeah, I like it. I bought this because it's just so nice foliage, so it's nice looking plant even if it's not in the bloom. And the next up is Palaeonopsis Super Stupid Gigantea. And I bought this because the name. I want the Super Stupid Orchid. And this is the hybrid of the two of. And this is just the seedlings, like the website said it's like 2 years from blooming, so this should be big orchid, but it's just a seedling. And here you can see 2 cuts that are glued. I glued those, and it's okay to glue orchids with super glue. And reason was this leaf was damaged. And I glued it because it was ripping more, so now it can't like rip off, so it's better to have glued leaf than rip it all whole off. And even if the glue isn't like working with this leaf, I can cut the whole leaf off, but hopefully I will save it up. And it wasn't damages in transport. It was after I unpackaged this. It was actually really mysterious thing. I unpackaged all of these and then I watered because they were weak in transport, so they were really dry. I sit then like on my kitchen sink and I was doing something else in the living room and I heard that noise that something fell down in the sink, and it was this orchid. It was just like fell down. I don't know why, maybe I positioned it poorly or something, but it was falling down and broken leaf, and I was so devastated. But hopefully it's now much better. Well, not better, it would be better it had no glue lines, but yeah, it has. Hopefully the leaves will be green and usable. And next one. And it has that Palaeonopsis Taisuko Cobalt and Sunrise Red Pioker. So it's Palaeonopsis. I love Palaeonopsis. I don't like other orchids that much. This has nice red tone in its leaves. And yeah, this is 2 seedling. It's 1 to 2 years from blooming, and it's more like 2 years. It leaves this miniature pot. And this one is Palaeonopsis Schilleriana. It's known for these funny spotted leaves. And that's the reason I bought this, I really liked it. And it has red underside, really red. I'm really enjoying, and this is blooming size, I think. Yeah, there are 4 leaves. And all of these 3 are still the pots they came. Yeah, they are just watered. And they have healthy roots and medium. I don't want to go like repotting them after they are shocked being in transport. So yeah. But this one has the flimsy plastic pot, so now it's living in the white pot. It's not ideal, I much rather have this in a clear pot to see how the roots going. But I couldn't find suitable size clear pot, so now it's in the white pot. But I hope I will not overwater this, because I'm not seeing the roots. I think I actually can see roots. Here down. There! No, there's water. Yeah, definitely not good drain. Hopefully I well, it goes on the floor. And I finished it. It's now ready to be hanged on my wall. And I really like how it turned out. It has many stages. But now I decided to leave it rough because I added this color. And this isn't like completely transparent, it actually left some marks. So I had to like go to patch this up, and because this is ultramud canvas, at some point acrylic start to do that, they don't stick that well on the surface, and it started to happening here, so I did leave it a little bit like rough. But I actually really like how the like the tentacles are rough, but the hat and the walking gang are much more refined. I like the look, and there's also the simple drop shadow on there, so yeah, I'm liking it. And I'm planning to put it up the wall, not where these other are hanging, but I think this side where the Darth Vader is hanging. And I think I will try to go like, this wall is for the... I have like goal to fill the whole wall with art, but as you can see my living room is huge, so yeah, that will be take some time. Yeah, let me show Ben Ben. Here is Ben Ben. Min. Hi. How's your day going? You have been sleeping all day. Like you usually do. Like eat a breakfast and then go to sleep. Take me some naps. Bunny nip. Aww, you're so cute. Aww. You're so such a cute. Aww. Porch. Yeah, here is Ben Ben. He has been really helping me to paint. Not really. He has actually been trying to knock over my easel. Which is actually that hard because... Oh, I think I will ramble a little bit about that subject too. This easel is really flimsy. It's dry, but it's not meant to like permanent easel, so... As you can see, it's really easy to like knock over. It's isn't tall enough or straight or anything. Oh, yeah. Now I have some cleaning to do. As you can see, I have like huge mess on my table, on both my tables. And I have the orchids paintings hanging from the moon to continue. So hopefully I will do toes there under the stuff. And then, well, cleaning first. I can't do anything if my workspace looking like this. But I really want to start new acrylic painting soon. I really enjoyed that acrylic painting. It's been really fun to do. I was really surprised because usually I don't enjoy acrylic painting, but this was fun. And I really want to try oils, but I'm not sure can I handle the total smell. I have water-soluble oils, but they still have some kind of smell. So yeah, that was my vlog this time. It was surprisingly art-related. That's not happened all the time. Yeah, now to clean this workspace. Hopefully I can see you how this look went all cleaned up.